much. In mathematics, there are talks about theorems, and talks about conjectures with evidences, and some talks without conjectures without evidences. And, I think you like 1 and 2, but you don't like 3 so much. But I am afraid that my talk is concerning this third subject. And I got old and my brain already collapsed. And so I lost the ability to study those 1 and 2. But because my brain is already collapsed. So everything became the same in my brain. And so I can connect anything, any different things as a same thing. So so this is a very big advantage to become old, yeah. the Vojta compares height functions. I will explain this one in C. And then here we have it to F is a number field and V is a algebraic variety of F. And I want to say that this is a distalk. So and then we assume that V is embedding as open of a projective algebraic variety. And MC we see the holomorphic functions from C, a complex plane to VC. And then this is actually a holomorphic functions to morphic functions F from C to V bar C. Such that if C is not contained in the boundary, C minus two minus B. This is about number theory, and this is about the Nevanlinna theory. And the subject here is to study is a question. How often F has similarity or polar or zero on C, and that is how often if Z belongs to V, the boundary. And this is Nevanlinna theory. And Vojta compares number theory and Nevanlinna theory, and he formulated many conjectures about comparing these two, and there are many results are known.
And L is a polarization.
What?
L.
Oh yeah, sorry. L is a nine band. L is a thank you very much. Nine band on V bus. And then, yeah. Now we can compare.
And what is R? TFL R.
TFL. This R is non-negative real number. Yeah. So R moves.
If FC is not contained in the boundary, not contained.
not contained in boundary. Yeah. Thank you very much. Yeah. So now, but then we can compare one and two, and then also the new height functions. Horizontal holomorphic. And concerning the period domain, there is a notion of the horizontal map. And then such map with this condition horizontal correspond to a variation of which is structure with log degeneration. On y with given Hodge numbers. Yeah, and also this is also according to morphisms from horizontal morphisms from y to x bar c. Here the morphism is here a capital pole or something right here. But this is a clearly movism. Such that if y is not inside the boundary. And here the x bar c is a partial toroidal partial compactification of XC which Kazuya and Nakayama and I defined. But this is not true compactification, but some partial compactification. And then here this is eigen, but here we don't talk so much about this one, so I don't explain so much. This is consisting of nilpotent orbits in the theory of degeneration of Hodge structures and orbits with rank together. This is we add some points called nilpotent orbits to XC, then we get X bar C, but we don't discuss too much. And then the deviation is that here you have a which is variation of structure H, and then H and F correspond to in the relation that this F and this H are F and H are F is a period map of H. That is at each point of Y, then if you restrict this H to that point Y, then a small point of y, then you get to the point of XC, the Hodge structure at each point. And so then you get such map. So that is called the period map that is at each point of Y, you have a usual Hodge structure. This is a variation of Hodge structure. So at each point, you have a Hodge structure. So, But there are similarities also, because you have a log designation. But if you use X bar, then that becomes a true homomorphism. And then the Nevanlinna theory here, this is the analog of Nevanlinna theory. But the subject here. How often this H
degenerates
on Y? Why is this C or this C? Yeah. And this is a theory of representation of Hodge structure. So this is some nice subject. Yeah. And then now I hope to define those height functions and this. And lambda is I will define lambda later. And so then those xc is not, this x is not usually not a algebraic variety, and so we cannot so this subject is not contained in the usual Nevanlinna theory. We cannot directly apply the construction of height functions in the usual Nevanlinna theory to this subject. And so now I define first that was section one, and then I define XC and this XM. We can consider the mixed motifs and mixed Hodge structures, but today I hope to make the story simpler. I will consider only a pure case, pure Hodge. Then we consider the pure case. That is we only consider pure motifs and pure Hodge structures. And so we fix integer W, which is weight, and HI for each integer Z, this is a Hodge number. And the condition is that H W minus 1 is H I, and H I is 0 for almost over 0, or Y for almost over Y. And we also fix H 0, H 0 Q. H 0 Q is a H0Q is a Q vector space of dimension HI, the sum of HI, and fix H0Q times H0Q to Q times 2 pi I to the minus W, minus W. This is non-degenerate pairing bilinear form, and symmetric if W is even, and anti-symmetric symmetric if W is odd. And then XC is written in the form of G plus minus times g g a q divided by t. Here, these are free domain, the period domain, and but we take a little bigger one. This is filtration. Increasing filtrations on H0C, tensor product of C and H0Q. And filtration is the cost of C vector subspace. Such that Q I divided by Y is minus one. This is a decreasing filtration. And the debate such that the dimension is HI. And then this is the polarization for that is a Hodge structure. This should be a Hodge structure. H0Q with this filtration and this pairing is polarized Hodge structure of weight W. And HD plus minus is the same thing, but here we take this zero or minus of that is you replace this by this is replaced by then you have t plus minus and g is a algebraic group So then you have reaction, and then K is we fix K, open compact subgroup of AFQF is the subgroup of G. And this AFQ is a this is a AFQ is a the non-arc media component of the component of the adjoining of yeah. And then you can this and then we have this M lambda pair. M is a motive over weight W, and such that the dimension of the Q I divided by Q I plus one. And then other conditions are that there is a polarization And lambda is a modulo k plus of AF Q tensor H0 Q to the total realization of N. Here the K can act here and then but then we take the module K class. This should be also and then there should be some condition that there is some polarization and also some on N and some isomorphism M this is benchy I forgot to say that F is ended in C. We embed F in C, this embedding in this. And this is a bit realization. So such that we have isomorphism between this and H0 Q, which sends this polarization to this sum times H0 up or something. And I think also and also this pairing should send also some D prime. Yes. I think this is it. Some part may be not perfectly precise, but I wrote preprint in which all decisions are written precisely. These precise things like about these written in a preprint which is not yet uploaded. Here is a height function for motifs it is in a fiber. But I had to correct many mistakes and the corrected version and also this corrected version and part two and part two will appear in archive soon. soon in archive. But maybe after 2 months or two weeks, I am completing this part too now. Yeah. So we don't see the appear there with the precise definition. Yeah. So then to have a nice theory, we should put a condition K, some neat condition on K, but I don't talk about this. This condition implies that the this map is locally isomorphism. I don't talk about this thing so much. Yeah. Now I hope to define a height function. Real numbers, CI are real numbers. I explain first the simplest part, the three. Then we have from C. And this is a variation of which structure on the C one's a projective smooth curve over complex number. And then this H lambda H is defined to be you have a variation of Hodge structure with log degeneration. Log degeneration contains that the local monism is important. And then by the theory of Dorigno, you have a vector bundle. Vector bundle on C. On C. And then with filtration, with which filtration. So this can have this similar point, but still this vector bundle. Vector bundle, which is C times H, the local system in the place of non-singularity, extends to the singular part point, points with singularity over which, and then by doing.
So you require the residue to be zero? Residue to be nilpotent?
Yeah, local monism is
assumed
to be.
Yeah, local monism is important, but on the boundary point, you have logarithmic connection, and you require residue to be nilpotent. Residue to be nilpotent.
Residue is nilpotent. I'm sorry, I forgot. Sorry. My local. H O, and this is the Hodge filtration. For Hodge filtration. Sorry. And you can take IHES. You take the degree of this vector bundle and then on this projective smooth curve, and then you multiply it by CI, and then you take the sum. Yes. And then next, to define a Nevanlinna version and the number theoretic version, I need some preparation. If H is a Hodge structure of weight W, the determinant is the highest for the power. And tensor determinant of W minus I is C. This is a one-dimensional vector space, has a canonical metric. Uh, is if you have a base A base and B base here, then the metric is defined to be a tensor B inverse. The metric of this element here is defined to be a A divided by B bar, and you take the absolute value. So this is, and then B, because B is inside H, because glu W minus I is identified with the Hodge W minus II part of this. And then we have alpha to alpha bar, complex conjugation. By complex conjugation, you have I omega minus I. And this is graded glue I of H. So you have a complex action of the complex conjugation from this to this, and then that extends to the determinant module. So you have B bar. B bar can be defined here, and it is also a basis. So you can take the ratio of two bases, and then this ratio is in C cross, and so you can take the absolute value there. Yeah, so this is a canonical metric, yeah. And then this height function for the Nevanlinna type is defined to be forever in homomorphism horizontal from C to XC. Horizontal morphisms. Then this corresponds to some H here. Yeah. H on C with log degeneration. The variation of this structure here. Yeah. And then the TF lambda R is defined to be 0 to R of the Z. R of the kappa I H, and you take T. And this kappa I H is the kappa form. Of the metrized line values, IHO, depth blue IHO tensor depth W minus I H O and include the numbers. And then at each point you have a metric, so this you have a this metric becomes can be extended on this that metric can be extended to this family. You have a family of metrics on this family of Hodge structure. And then you can take the curvature form. Curvature form is actually and you take one over two because this I and here we compare this to this. Here only you have blue I, but this W minus I plays a role of the this is the degree of this is minus of that and by the polarization. So this is like twice of this.
So you take CS power and the product of I.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. Oh yeah. Thank you very much. This is CS.
Ah, sum.
Sum. Like. And then, so, and then the curvature home is, something ID, if you are in the local basis. And this is the metric for this line. And this doesn't depend on the choice of the.
You don't take log?
Oh, thank you. And then this doesn't depend on the local basis, the choice of the local basis, so that it can be defined. And actually, this has some similarity at the point. This is a two form, differential two form, but that has some small similarity at the point H has a similarity, but still this integral converge can be defined. Then this is so that this is a story two. And for story one, the number story two, and then if you have a motif for M in X, then you define each lambda M to be a product of HI M CI. And this, but here, here to define this height function, here we fix H0Z, Z structure of H0Q, such that the K is such that Z hat to H0Z is stable under the action of K, such lattice, Z lattice, Z structure exists. And we fix, and my former student Koshikawa proved that the height doesn't depend so much of the choice, so much on the choice of the such integral structure. That is one of his main results, about the height of the choice. But here HIM. Oh. HIM but here HIM is defined to be XV minus 1 over 2. And here you define M to be determinant of guru I M to RAM tensor determinant of guru W minus I M to RAM and you take a minus one. And then X is inside, X is a element of another element of M. And then here we range over all places of F. And if V is Archimedean, then it corresponds to embedding of F into C. Then you have a Hodge realization of this in C. Then you have a metric on L. On L is as above. And you can define it. Yeah. And if V is non-Archimedean, this norm on metric on L at V is defined by the periodic integral theory, integral periodic theory, integral periodic Hodge theory of and shorts. That is they have some OB lattice they have some integral structure on this thing. Because you fixed such such thing. Sorry. I forgot to say that in the definition of the lambda, K-level structure, lambda, I forgot to say that this should satisfy the condition that the Galois action for sigma in the Galois group, then the level structure should satisfy such condition. The Galois action is representative. Then by this, then this is got Z hat lattice is Galois stable in M eta. And so then if you have in this theory they don't need any Galois action to define the ERP integral structure. This is not necessary, but anyway, I forgot to assume this. This is
question from Paris.
Question. Can I ask?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yes, okay, so I want to ask an elementary question on your definitions, because you take the sum over all I, so you have the in both the analytic and motivic things. So let's say take the analytic first. So you have I and W minus I. So because you have a Hodge number, C of I is equal to CW minus I, and the line
by HI is
what
CI is any and HI was HW minus I. And so CI is taken arbitrary. Yeah, so CI are any.
Ah, okay. Excuse me. So another question is that when you're using integral periodic Hodge theory, do you assume some good reduction or
No. The good reduction is not assumed. Any reduction is okay. Bad reduction is okay. And they have a nice result in the case of good reduction. But actually, in the comparison with geometric theory, they have in the case of good reduction, they have good interpretation of their integral structure by using crystalline drop homology, integral drop homology. But they also extended it to the semi-stable reductions, and also, I forgot the name of the person. Other person also did it.
Cessnavicius extended to semi-stable case.
Cessnavicius.
Qu'est-ce que tu dis?
Yes. Thank you very much. He also did it in the semi-stable. So that is the integral structure is here defined by their theory without any interpretation first. And in the good reduction case, they show that their integral structure is actually integral drag homology in the geometric case, in the good reduction case. But semi-stable generalization of the semi-stable reduction case was already done. And so their integral structure is very nice. And now, we have this definition. And then we have many questions. I just introduce some few questions, but if you open the papers of Vojta, then he has many conjectures in the comparison of the number theory and the Nevanlinna theory. So then we can transport their problems his problems to this situation. And we have many new problems, and I can formulate infinitely many conjectures without any evidence. conjectures without evidence. Very much. So, today I only introduce some of them. So, for example, the questions for each lambda, each zero, all C and all H are is it equivalent to each there exists some C such that each lambda m is C F Q for all F and all M in XM. Well, this is question and then also you can all F and all R you have TF lambda R. So that is lambda is if you have you consider the same lambda then you have three types of height functions for the same lambda and then we ask that they have some common properties or that and maybe here maybe not equivalent, but here there is a Nevanlinna theory concerning not only C, but concerning the ramified covering of C, a complex plane. And then if you put such generalization, then maybe you have a equivalence. So this is question. Griffiths and Peters. We have the problem. So let lambda the lambda equal star means here. Ci is I for all I. Ci was the numbers, real numbers used in the definition of lambda. The Griffiths and Peters proved that the fact is that H star H is always non-negative. And H star H is zero for the variation of Hodge structure means that H is constant. And this special number. R is non-negative. And TF star lambda is bounded above means that F is constant. Such a thing can be proved by using the theorem. And so, actually, this height function, H star, was defined by Griffiths long ago. I am generalizing this definition to more general height functions. This can be also. This follows also from the theory. So then we can naturally ask that conjecture zero is that the finiteness is that the M such that the height is such thing is fine. The in the classical Nevanlinna theory such property of the Nevanlinna height function corresponds to this property for the number-theoretic height function. So we are imitating that for such comparison volume. And so then conjecture two is, I can define so called, I can formulate the so called Vojta conjecture, but it is, I need more preparations to for that. So here I present some simple form of Vojta conjecture, not the exact analog of the Vojta conjecture. Yeah, that is there exists some B such that first So for a motif M in over F of non-Archimedean place of M, such that M is bad reduction, this is some C should be. If F is given, then there is something. Such that for lambda non star in B B times C. Yeah. And this is what as this two is that that two is that for C and H on C, then you have X is in C, H has bad reduction. So this is for maybe one, this is for one, this is for three. This H has similarity at X is like B times H star H. This is otherwise with TF, TF star R or R. Yeah. So these parts are replaced by those parts about the singularity. Yeah.
Well, what is the role of this C?
Our C! Oh, thank you very much. C. You know, we have plus, thank you very much.
Uh-huh.
Plastic, yeah. These are some form of Vojta, not exactly, and to communicate perfectly the Vojta conjecture, I need to know about preparation, so I just introduce some.
The C here depends on F.
Yeah, but also if, yes, and so, yes. Yes, I did. As I said, I have no evidence. So I am just imitating the paper of Vojta. And so if you find that you can show that these are not true, then please make papers and on that these are not true, and then please forget the light conjecture. So I'm just happy to bring such subjects of study to you. that is maybe a duty of all the past. the Séminaire conjecture or motifs can be is in XF. This is the finite set of places. This is the F containing all Archimedean places. Then N is the reduction outside this. Fully finite. And this conjecture is supported by one. By one and conjecture one. Because here if you fix the set of places, then if it is a good reduction, if even is a good reduction outside this, then this part appears only V in S can contribute for such M. So then this part is bounded. And then by this, this such M should be bounded.
I have a question.
Maybe I
don't remember exactly, but you just spoke about a statement that you called one, capital one, and there was a notation N of V. What was N of V?
M.
N of V in one. One capital one is a conjecture or a theorem?
capital one is a conjecture or a theorem?
Ah, conjecture, conjecture, all those are conjectures.
Conjecture.
Yes, conjecture 1 plus 3 plus 3. Yeah, yeah. No, no.
Thank you.
So I have to finish the story, but then there is also this is supported by also supported by the fact that supported by the fact that C to X C horizontal morphism morphism without similarity, horizontal holomorphic map is constant. If you don't allow the similarity, then you have only a constant map. So this can be proved by using some Hodge theory. So then in the new classical Nevanlinna theory, such property corresponds to such property that the VVV VOF by Y is finite, or such thing is this is also conjecture, OVF and OVN. This is some version of the conjecture of Lang, that is this is a so-called Brody hyperbolicity. And a hyperbolic variety has only finitely many rational points is Lang's conjecture, and this is some version of his conjecture. And so I think that classical comparison of Nevanlinna and number theory, then you have such conjecture. And so then if such analogue is true, then this is a fact. This is a fact. So this supports this issue. Thank you very much.
Oh, thank you very much. So we first ask a question from Paris. So,
other questions? First,
yes.
Okay. So there is no questions in Paris.
Okay. So then, no, how about Beijing?
Yes. Sorry.
Questions.
Yes.
In the work of Fatims on abelian varieties. He has a height of abelian varieties, and the first step is to interpret this height as a height of a point in a modular space.
Oh yeah.
Is it a case in some cases of your height, or is it?
Yeah. So that is we don't have the interpretation of this set as usually we don't have the variety of waves. We have no good theory of modular space of motifs. So we cannot prove the finiteness. If this is what the algebraic variety and this is a equivariant point, and then we have a finiteness. And in the case of Hartings, then the abelian variety is understood as motifs, but the modular space of motif abelian varieties was really a algebraic variety, so this finiteness follows from the theory of height of algebraic varieties. But in this motif version, we don't have such good understanding of the modular space of motifs, so we have no. At present, I have no way to prove the finiteness. Yeah. But my dream is that by using Langlands correspondences, the motifs should correspond to the automorphic forms. So the finiteness may be proved by studying automorphic forms, but by replacing motifs by automorphic forms. But at present I have no good idea to go that direction.
Thank you. So that's all from Paris.
Okay, then a question from Beijing.
Hello. There are no questions from Beijing.
Then I have some questions from Tokyo. So you formatted a conjecture for this field domain. So is there some periodic analog for using periodic field domain?
I wanted to define periodic heights for motifs, general motifs, but I have no good idea. Yeah, so periodic version should exist. Those are Archimedean values. Those heights are Archimedean values. As Archimedean values, even as the finite places. Yeah, so there should be a theory of periodic heights. Yes, yes.
Any other questions? Okay, thank you very much.